Do you want to add a progress bar to your videos? Stick around because I'll be showing you how you can easily and quickly add a video progress bar to your videos to make it look from this to this. Coming up. Okay, let's jump right into it. We'll be using an online video editor called Kapwing. Now, there's not going to be any installation involved because everything will be done through your internet browser, which means you can use Kapwing on your computer, you can use it on your tablet, and even your phone. Okay, so if you're ready, go ahead, open up your internet browser, and go type in www.kapwing.com. Click on sign in. Now, I would highly encourage you to sign in or register yourself for a free account because with a free account, it helps you create your videos without a watermark. You're able to save your content to a workspace, and there are some other features that get unlocked as well. Okay, so once you have signed in, you will be greeted by a page that looks something like this. So basically, this is your workspace. Now, let's go ahead and click on Tools and add a progress bar to video. Go ahead and click Get Started. And then on this page, you can choose to start with a blank slate or blank canvas, or you can choose to upload your file. What I'm going to do is to upload my file, and I can also drag and drop my video into the browser. Once your video has been uploaded, you will then see this screen. This is basically the studio mode, right? Where you can see all these different options, okay? So the first thing that I'd like you to do is to click on Lock Ratio. This prevents your video from getting cropped whenever you resize it. Now, the second thing that I need you to do is to think about where you want to upload this video. Just click anywhere outside of the image, and then on the right hand side you'll be able to see different output sizes. Now, I am going to be uploading this video to IG Stories, so it's going to be a vertical video. A vertical video ratio would be 9:16, so which I am going to be clicking on. So as you can see right now, it switches to a vertical video mode. If I want to put this video on Instagram feed, for example, which is a square, then it's 1:1. Alright, so depending on where you want to upload it to or what kind of format that you want, this is where you decide. I am going to resize my video to make it look a little more larger so that it can cover a bit more of the blank spaces. Next, I'm going to be adding the progress bar. Okay, so how do I go about doing that? I will click on elements at the top here, and then the option for add a progress bar will appear. Click on that, and then you can see at the bottom here, this is the progress bar. Now, you can't see anything yet, but if I press play, you'll be able to see the progress bar playing. Okay, I'm going to click pause for a minute and then show you that you can actually change the color based on your preference. Okay, you can change it to red, even blue. That's really up to you. In fact, if you know the color code, if you click on it, you can insert your own color code if you like, or there are even more options for colors right here. If you want to even be more specific in terms of the colors, you can click on this droplet here, and then you can choose the color that you like. Great. But in this instance, I'm just going to change it to red. I'm going to make it a little bit larger so that it's easier to see. And then that's it. That's basically it. You've already added a progress bar to your videos. I'm just going to make a few more adjustments to this whole thing so it looks a little bit nicer, and then I'm going to shift this thing down a bit, and this area here does look a little plain, so I'm just going to add text. How do I go about adding text? Just a quick tip, click on text and then the text will appear. Double click on it and change it to whatever it is that you want. Simple one. All right, what if I want to change the background color? I can change it to black, and there it goes. Okay. Alright, so once you have done that, all you need to do is then go ahead to export video, click on it, and then the video will be created. Once you've done that, you can see a small little preview of your video, and then you can choose to download. If you want to continue editing it, you can. You can even make a copy of the studio mode of the video that you've done earlier. It's really up to you, okay? There you have it. Now you can easily and quickly add a progress bar to your videos using Kapwing. Now that's gonna do it for today's video. Please like, subscribe, and share this video. And if you have any questions, please let me know in the comments below. Thank you for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one. See ya.